Hello friends, Ragini here. This is mock test 19, okay, for UGC NET NTA related important MCQs for electronic science and other PSU exams. Okay, so let's have a look on the following questions. The switching speed of P plus N junction depends primarily on, let me explain you one thing very clearly. Whenever you have given as P plus, then it means heavily duped. When it is given P plus plus, then it means very much heavily duped. Very much heavily duped. Okay. What here it is given? Here it is given as P plus N junction. What it is? P plus N junction. That means it is heavily duped P region. It depends primarily on the C. This P plus N junction depends, this P plus N junction depends primarily upon the lifetime of the majority carriers. Here all majority carriers, lifetime of majority carriers in the N region. Because lifetime of majority carriers, that means electrons, that means majority carriers are electrons, okay, in N region, which is likely to, majority carriers electrons in N region, which is likely to. N region is, so the switching speed mainly depends upon the lifetime of the majority carriers, that is electrons in the N region, which is likely duped. So this fourth one is the right answer. Next question. In a Zener diode, let me explain you one thing, that this is Zener diode. In a Zener diode, both P and N regions are heavily duped. Both P and N regions are heavily duped, and duping ratio. What is the duping ratio? We can say that the duping ratio is around, duping ratio of Zener diode is 1:10^5. So the right answer will be C option. Both P and N regions are heavily duped. Next question. In a junction diode, we are talking about the junction diode. See, you know that whenever there is a space, there will be a capacitance, okay? If there are two metallic plates and there is a space between them, whether it is dielectric, there is a capacitance. C is equal to epsilon A upon D. I can also write it as epsilon A upon W. So this W is what? It is depletion width. That means this C is inversely proportional to depletion width. Okay. Now, depletion capacitance always acts under reverse bias condition. If you can see in all these four options, what we have given, depletion capacitance. So remember that depletion capacitance always acts under reverse bias condition. Okay. So this depletion capacitance, this depletion width is inversely proportional to this depletion width is proportional to under root of reverse bias voltage. Okay, that means this C is inversely proportional to VRB. Okay, this C is inversely proportional to reverse bias voltage. That means C increases if VRB reduces, and it reduces if VRB increases. That means depletion capacitance decreases with increase in reverse bias. So which option will be true? This B option will be true, that the depletion capacitance decreases with increase in the reverse bias, since C is inversely proportional to 1 upon under root VRB. Always remember. Next, fourth question. For a PN junction, match the type of breakdown with phenomena. See, avalanche breakdown. Avalanche means what? Avalanche means collision of carriers. There is a heavy collision of carriers with crystal ions. So first A, Zener breakdown is rupture of covalent bonds due to strong electric field. Covalent bonds will be broken up as soon as there is a electric field. Means electric field is what? F is equal to QE. Electric field is force per unit charge. When there is a heavy force, that means heavy electric field has to be applied. So the covalent bonds will be broken up. And then when the covalent bonds will be broken up, the number of EHPs will be generated, electron hole pairs. So Zener breakdown, it is Second, C, rupture of covalent bonds to strong electric field. Punch through is related to early effect. Third, B, that means we have first A, second C, third B. Fourth option is right answer. Next question, the diffusion capacitance of a PN junction. Now, always remember, depletion capacitance acts under reverse bias condition and diffusion capacitance acts under forward bias condition. So we have CD, this is diffusion capacitance, this is equal to tau IF upon eta VT. Now this VT is a thermal temperature, tau IF upon eta KT by Q. Okay, now remember, this CD, if it is proportional to IF and KT, if I say, if the other things are kept constant. Now, diffusion capacitance will decrease with decreasing current and increasing temperature. This is thermal temperature. KT if CD is inversely proportional to the temperature. If temperature rises, CD has to be reduced. So, it decreases with decreasing current and increasing temperature. So, the right option will be fifth B. Okay, so thank you. Please like my channel and share and subscribe. Very important questions, very interesting questions. Please do like my channel and share it. More